Trump takes no responsibility for spike in disinfectant calls. In an April 23 press briefing, U.S. President Donald Trump dangerously suggested that using disinfectant inside could help treat patients diagnosed with the coronavirus. At the same briefing, Trump suggested that sunlight could also treat coronavirus-positive patients. He had just stopped encouraging the use of the anti-malaria drug hydroxychloroquine in the fight against COVID-19, and the two new treatments he suggested were immediately met with widespread criticism. Trump cited a very nice rumor that sunlight could have an effect on viruses and asked U.S. Coronavirus Task Force Coordinator Dr. Deborah Birx if light could be applied to cure COVID-19. She said not as a treatment. He then wondered if disinfectants could be used as a potential treatment by injection inside or almost a cleaning. Trump made this comment after hearing a U.S. official speak about research into bleach having the ability to kill the novel coronavirus in minutes. The next day, he defended himself by explaining he was only asking a question sarcastically to reporters just to see what would happen. CNN reports that U.S. hotline calls concerning disinfectant use have risen since Trump's comments. On April 26, the governors of the states of Michigan and Maryland blamed Trump for the spike, considering that medical professionals have long warned that disinfectants are poisonous if ingested. Maryland had previously had to issue a statewide alert against the ingestion or injecting of disinfectants after Trump's press briefing. On April 27, a reporter at the president's COVID-19 news conference mentioned the spike in Maryland's emergency hotline calls after Trump's comments. Trump responded by saying, "I can't imagine why. I can't imagine that." He also said he does not take responsibility for the increase in calls. According to the Huffington Post, the New York City Poison Control Center also reported 30 calls about exposure to household chemicals just hours after Trump's comments. The center reported only 13 calls during the same period in 2019. The manufacturer of disinfectants Lysol and Dettol had to issue their own statement as well, saying, "Under no circumstance should our disinfectant products be administered into the human body through injection or any other route." When asked about the use of bleach injections to treat COVID-19, New Zealand's Director General of Health, Dr. Ashley Bloomfield, fell silent before saying, "I don't think I need to comment on that."